Hi guys, today we are going to start a new topic, Input-Output in C Language. I'm Dr. Shantanu Kule, Associate Professor in BVIT. Now, let's see what we are doing. Now this is input-output in C language. In C language, there are several ways to take inputs from keyboard, and we can also take outputs onto monitor. Now, C language, this is the mother of all languages. It was developed by AT&T Bell Laboratories in USA. Now, input and output. First, we'll take about scanf statement. We are going for scanf statement. What scanf is? Scanf is a function. In all functions, they use parentheses and there is a semicolon. Semicolon is used. It indicates that the function has been an end. Now, input function is scanf. And there is an output function that is called printf. This is output function. Now, scanf and printf, both the functions are discussed into stdio.h file. What? stdio.h file. What is it? It's a standard. The full form of stdio is standard input and output. And hash include is used. Here hash is called preprocessor. And include means this file has been included in C language, where the definition of scanf and printf function is described in stdio.h file. Now, let's start with an example first. First, as usual, as we have said, has include stdio.h. Then we need to write main function. And within main function, we have to write the whole program. Now, if we want to take a number as input, it may be integer, it may be character, it may be a string number. Let's take an example. We are taking example of an integer variable. A is an integer here. We can use A, we can initialize A as A equal to 1, A equal to 2. But as we have scanf statement, we will use this scanf statement as scanf, scanf, then there is double inverted comma and percent d is used this is our first parameter, and there is ampersand a, it is used. Now this is our first parameter, this is our second parameter. We can use any number of parameters, but a pair of parameters should be used, where percent %d describes us, it's a decimal, d for decimal. Now in place of d, we can use f for floating point numbers, we can use c for character numbers. Now how will proceed? See, now this is printf statement. This is printf is used for output, as we have already said. Printf is used for output, and the syntax is more or less same. Whereas in scanf statement we use ampersand, here in printf statement we have not used it. Why? Because whenever we need to take input, there must have some places where it may be in your RAM, random access memory. In random access memory, there are some particular place. That place should be identified by the address. The address in RAM. Where is the address? Ampersand is used for address. Used for address. Now, A is there for output. Now we will proceed further in this program. Here, let's see. Get CH, this statement is used to stop the screen for some time, and there is an end. Now this is, all these things are happening within main function. This is our main function, and this is our opening bracket, and this is our closing bracket. Within main function the whole program runs. Now we have learned how to take input and how to take output in a C program. Now there are, as we have said, there are several ways to take input in C language. There is scanf statement and printf statement. Besides it, there are get char statement and put char statement, get char and put char statements are there in C language, where we can take a character as input and we can print a character as output. The general syntax, we can use it as a variable name equal to get char. Variable name equal to get char. And how it is used? Now, this is the example, like int name, and name equal to get char. Now whenever we take input a character, obviously char, here char represents a character. A single character could be taken as input into get char statement, and this character would be reflected on this name variable. Name is a variable. Sorry, we have to declare it as char. This is char. One character variable is being declared first, and then this character variable, it will take a particular character whatever it will be taken input from keyboard. Now, in what situations we use get char and put char statement? Suppose there are some yes no conditions. If there is some yes or no conditions we have to do in our programming, in such cases we use get char and put char. Like suppose there is a program where it is said, are you a male or female? Now answer, you have to answer like either yes or no. There is no option, no other options. So there is if then else statement. We can omit then if else statement. Using if else statement, we use this particular thing. Now we are going to start that example. Let's see. If name equal to capital Y should be in single quotation, or there is or condition, these are called pipes, and name equal to small y, printf. I'm a gentleman. Else we can use it as I'm a woman or like that. But before that, whenever this name variable we have already declared as care, now this is how the whole program works. Care name variable is declared first, then name variable will take a particular input, either it will be y or it will be no, n, y for yes, n for no. And it is, as we know, c is case sensitive, that's why we have taken capital Y as well as small y. In this case we have omitted N situation, means no situation. We have only taken the single one, that is if name equal to y or name equal to small y, printf, I'm a gentleman. Else we can do whatever we need to do. Now this is how get care statement is used. Similarly, put care statements could be used to print a particular thing. That means this y could be printed like put care and then within bracket the variable name. Now get care and put care both are being in use. Thank you.